Hello, folks. Rodrigo Werle, assistant professor of agronomy and cropping systems, extension weed scientist at University of Wisconsin-Madison. I'm here today to address a topic I've been receiving questions on, which is the potential carryover of herbicides into an industrial hemp crop. As of 2018, in Wisconsin and also in other states, it became legal to grow industrial hemp as a crop. Okay, and because of the recent change in the farm bill with industrial hemp going from a narcotic into a commodity crop, we anticipate to have a lot more acres planted with this crop in the 2019 growing season. In 2018, most of the hemp, industrial hemp fields here in the state of Wisconsin were under organic systems. So the topic of discussion here wasn't as relevant then. However, with the expansion and more interest in growing industrial hemp into conventional systems, this becomes an important point of discussion here, okay? So there's two topics here. As of now, as April of 2019, there are no synthetic pesticides labeled for use in industrial hemp, okay? So there are no synthetic herbicides that can be used for weed control in industrial hemp. So have a solid plan for your weed management program. If you're going to be growing this crop, if you obtain a license, which is necessary here in the state of Wisconsin, try to place this crop in fields with low weed pressure and then take advantage of the mechanical strategies and some alternative strategies available out there. Okay. Second point I want to visit about, and that's the focus of this short presentation here, is the potential for carryover. Okay. In our conventional systems where herbicides, synthetic herbicides are used, farmers are struggling with herbicide-resistant weeds such as water hemp, giant ragweed, and some other species out there. And a strategy, a recommended strategy to manage these weeds is to use soil-applied herbicides in your corn, your soybeans, and also other crops. The caveat here is that all the soil-applied herbicides, they usually have a rotation restriction, okay, or a planting interval there in order to minimize potential subsequent crop injury, okay? And since industrial hemp, it's a new crop here, it hasn't been introduced or it hasn't been studied, so it hasn't, you know, it's not part of the current herbicide labels, okay? So when you're looking through a rotation restriction there, industrial hemp is gonna fall under other crops. Okay, so I'm just going to walk you through a couple labels here. I'm going to pick two commonly used corn herbicides and two commonly used soybean herbicides, and I'll tell you what the rotation restriction is. Okay, so atrazine, it's a common herbicide used across the corn belt as a primary soil-applied herbicide, provides residual activity and also burn down established small weeds used in most of the corn production acres. And if you go to the label there, you're going to have your rotation restrictions here, which is specified in the Atrax label here in this instance. And you can see this note. Okay, and as this note says here, I'm just going to read the last part, is to avoid illegal residue and crop injury, do not plant any crop other than those on this label within 18 months following treatment, okay? And industrial hemp would fall under this category here. So if you sprayed, if you had corn last year, okay, and you were thinking about planting industrial hemp in that field this year, that is not allowed. Okay, so you need at least 18 months in that particular field without atrazine in order to plant. Another commonly used herbicide is Callisto or Mesotrione. There are several products out there. Okay, and if you go here, again, industrial hemp is going to fall under unspecified rotational crops. So there is an 18-month interval similar to atrazine. I'm switching gears now. I'm going to pick a commonly used herbicide in soybeans that has soil residual activity, and that's pursued or imazethapyr. It's an ALS herbicide. And this herbicide here, the rotation there, it's actually 40 months, okay? And prior to planting, farmers are encouraged to take soil samples 40 months after and run a bioassay if they're going to grow any crop that's not listed in this table, okay? So if you're sprayed pursued rimazepyr in your soybeans in the 2018 growing season, you would have to wait 40 months in order to be able to plant industrial hemp within that field, okay? Another commonly used pre-emergent herbicides in soybean is Spartan. Okay, and for Spartan, again, industrial hemp is not listed in their rotation table here, so you would have to go towards the end here, and that says a minimum of 12 months. Okay, so what I want to point out is that most of the soil applied herbicides that we recommend for management of herbicide resistant weeds in corn and soybean production, that restriction interval there is a minimum of 12 months. 18 months is pretty common, but as you just saw here, 40 months is also an example. Okay, so it's important that you understand what you sprayed in your fields in the previous year if you're going to be growing industrial hemp in conventional fields this year. And also moving forward, if you intend to grow industrial hemp in your conventional fields, you have to plan your herbicide program accordingly. Okay, the label is the law. You got to follow the law. You don't want to break the rules here for two reasons. The law is the law, and the second thing is to minimize potential for injury, okay, into your crop as well. So this is just a quick update. If growing industrial hemp in conventional systems, pay attention to what was sprayed before and adjust as you move forward. Okay, stay tuned for more updates like this one. Thank you.